She tried to talk me off the ledge, but I only moved back a bit. It was late in the afternoon, and I was suiting up for walking the dog on a cold January day, muttering under my breath and slamming drawers that had done me no wrong. "What's the matter?" she asked in her gentle way. "I'm mad as hell and not fit to be with. Please respect yourself by staying away from me. I'm so damn mad I'm trying to stay away from myself." She insisted on walking with me, so instead of grunting to myself as I walked the dog, I spoke mostly complete sentences. "I'm so goddamn mad that 4,000 of my countrymen are dying every day. President doesn't give a shit, told us his level of care directly by saying, 'I'm not responsible for anything.' That comment was aimed specifically at anything having to do with our mass death pandemic. So of course I don't expect any action from him to protect and defend the American people. You know, the ones dying at the rate of 4,000 per day. But there's a commission specifically tasked with distributing vaccines and getting them into the arms of Americans. And now, weeks after vaccines were available, we've managed to vaccinate just 9 million people, while tens of millions more vaccine doses are sitting uselessly in freezers. And 4,000 of us are dying every day. That's one every 22 seconds. Go ahead, look at your watch or your iPhone timer and count off the deaths, one every 22 seconds. And every single one of those deaths is somebody's mom or dad or grandma or grandpa or brother or sister or son or daughter or friend or coworker or neighbor or the guy at the convenience store. Those who have died lost their lives. The survivors have lost their hearts. And that goddamn incompetent distribution commission continues to bumble. That's why I'm furious. Now President Burn It All Down has incited insurrection, sedition. He's attempted to neuter the Congress, to violate every voter, and take over the country to become a fascist dictator. His mobs have the same certainty that they're on the side of justice and what's right, that they're the true patriots and that God is on their side, as does Al-Qaeda and ISIS and the World War II Nazis and the Hutus and Slobodan Milosevic's army of ethnic cleansing thugs and all the rest of the genocidal maniacs. This time the terrorists, the killers, and the rampagers are our countrymen. Our domestic terrorists believe they're the true good guys because President Burn It All Down has told them so. He's told them he loves them. Here's what I'll tell you. We've always had a significant minority of citizens who hate, who dearly love to hate. I want to be bigger than this, but the truth is that right now I hate them. I fantasize about violently dragging those slimes off the walls of our Capitol building and of beating the hell out of the vandals who beat the hell out of our beautiful windows and doors of that building. I want to smash those who are trying to smash our Constitution. My dad and 16 and a half million of his generation served in the military in World War II. 405,399 of them died in Europe to end Nazism. On behalf of my dad and his compatriots in that awful war, our greatest generation says loud and clear that you goddamn neo-Nazis are an American disgrace. You are everything we know to be wrong. That's why I'm so damned angry. In some ways, what is even worse is the cabal of hypocritical, cowardly, manipulating cretins in Congress who've enabled and even encouraged the hate and violence. Not out of some warped sense of patriotism, but for individual, stupidly selfish personal gain. And we've known of their treachery for years, and they have gotten away with it. That's why I'm livid. The thing is, there are truly a lot of patriotic Americans on that ledge with me. That doesn't ease my anger, but they and I know right from wrong and will not stand for anything less than full punishment for those who did those awful things. I expect that a lot of us will continue to be on that ledge until the balance of justice is restored. Meanwhile, the domestic terrorists have promised more violence and hate in D.C. and in our state capitals this weekend and on an inauguration date. So, memo to DHS, the National Guard, and all the agencies that somehow managed to come out and beat the hell out of Black Lives Matter protesters. Here's the memo. Show up and do your job this time. I don't give a damn what President Doesn't Give a Shit or Burn It All Down says to you. Do your goddamn job. On January 6th, they failed us. They failed to do their job. Now the Capitol building is desecrated and four people are dead. That's why I'm on the ledge. I'm Jack Altshuler.